Hello and welcome to Something Green on NDTV Hop. Today we come to you from a restaurant called La Latina. It's located in GK1 N Block in New Delhi. Today we are going to meet Chef Aman Jaiswal, who is going to teach us two dishes. Let's see what he's cooking. Well, Chef Aman Jaiswal is going to teach us how to make a seafood paella. Chef, what are the key ingredients we require?
So we are making a classic seafood paella. So we basically need like seafood. So we have clams, we have mussels, we have rock shrimp, we have king prawn, and we have some vegetables like peas, zucchini, and peppers. Yeah.
Okay. And
this is sofrito. Basically, it's a spread. So it's cherry tomato grated with the onion, olive oil, and oregano together.
Do you buy it prepackaged or does
no,
one
we
have
are,
to make
we are
it?
Making in-house.
Okay,
yeah.
Alright.
Or if you want, you are making at home, you can just replace it with the tomato paste. Yeah.
Okay.
So we keep some tomato paste as well. And
paprika. And what is this?
So this is the garlic puree.
Okay.
Yeah. And we are using paprika, so pimento.
Yeah. Okay. Great. And which rice do we use?
So it's bomba rice.
Okay.
Bomba, yeah.
Is it any specific rice?
Yes, this is specific for the paella.
Okay.
And it's if you're not getting the exact rice, so you can replace with the arborio at home, yeah.
All right. And if you don't get arborio, can you just use basmati?
No.
No.
You can't do
okay.
That. That's
all
the
right.
Least. Like if you're on. That's for the home, yeah. Basically,
okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Great. Let's begin.
Yeah. Sure. So. We'll put the olive oil.
Is it a special?
Yeah, this is the
dish?
Special pan. Yeah, for the
okay.
Paella.
What so, is it made of?
So it's a iron.
Okay, and yeah. What is it called?
So this is the paella pan.
Paella pan.
Yeah.
All right.
So we are just putting the oil in.
And how many ml of oil is there?
So around 80-85 ml for four portions.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, this is olive oil.
Yeah, this all is right. A Spanish olive oil.
Okay.
So we'll season our pan like in the beginning. So it's help you to like not stick the ingredient
right.
In the bottom. Yeah, just work like a non-stick pan then. So we'll start with the vegetables. So I'll put this in first. So we can add this peppers too. Just stir a bit, not much, because when you add the stock, it will like cook. So yeah, a very little.
And instead of these vegetables, anything else one can
yeah,
add
you can,
or minus?
You can put like after the preparation, if you want, you can put some artichoke, some asparagus if you want. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Why not?
And within the preparation, what can be minus or add?
So it depends. Like if you are making the veg paella, so the quantity of the vegetable will be like increasing.
Okay.
Definitely. Yeah, so we can add the garlic puree. It's a good amount of garlic puree. I love garlic, so you.
Okay. And this is only pure garlic, or is it mixed
with
something?
This is pure garlic.
So how many cloves of garlic is
it? So it's like 7 to 8 cloves of garlic.
Okay.
Yeah.
Looks like more.
Yeah. No,
this
when
is
you this is 8 to 10, like you can say.
Really?
Yeah. And we'll use a bit of tomato puree too. I'm using less because I already used the sofrito, so
all right.
Yeah.
Is It's interesting how garlic and tomato is the base of food worldwide.
Yes,
right?
it's give you the body to the food.
Yeah.
And if you're cooking any gravy, like it gives the body, that's the soul.
Any place in the world that does not use garlic and tomato?
I don't think so. So we're adding rock shrimp. And we cook slowly. And if you need like bit more oil, you can add it on.
Okay.
Yeah. So now these three we can top it with the seafood on top.
Alright.
Now we're adding a bit of paprika, smoke, and bit of. This is very tasty if you want. Like this is the smoked paprika we're gonna try.
I love it because
sure.
Sometimes it makes vegetarian food
yeah.
taste like it has bacon in it.
Yeah, so you can try that. That's the same one. You get the bacon and chorizo's flavor.
I'm a huge fan.
Yeah.
You can add it to your omelets as well at home.
Yeah.
And they would
That's
taste
great.
Exotic.
Yeah. So I'm adding this rice.
Oh, so this rice, is it pre-boiled or is it
No,
it's like
the, it's,
oh,
it's
really?
Raw. Yeah.
So you just put it in the pan.
Yeah. Yeah.
And it just ready to eat.
Yeah, but like
how long do you need to cook it?
So it's around 22 minutes.
Oh, you need to cook it for
yes.
20 minutes.
So while doing this, we'll keep it separate and
All
we
right.
can start with the second.
Good idea.
Yeah.
So what are you adding next?
So I'm putting seafood saffron stock. We saute the onion, celery, leek together with the saffron, and we boil it. We mix it with the seafood and give a nice boil until 20 minutes. Then we strain it. This is the extraction of that.
Okay.
And we are putting in. Yeah. So this is measured. Like it's if you are adding 250 gram of rice, you can add 650 ml of stock.
Okay.
And we have some clams.
These are oysters, and that's the clam.
This is the mussels, green mussels, yeah. And put the prawn in.
And anything you'd like to say about cleaning all the seafood?
Yeah, of course. We have to devein it. So I didn't make a mark. I put a toothpick here and just pull it off. So you get the vein out.
Okay.
So this is the proper way to clean. And please don't forget to remove this part. This is very soft. If you try to have it, it might be like pinch you. So this is it so far. Just on slow. I love to sprinkle some this paprika. I just love it. I just love it. It's another good smelling, like good smoky flavor. You can try. So now the aroma is coming from here. So I can take it.
Well, it smells delightful.
Yes.
And now we let it cook for 20-25 minutes.
Yes.
Well, as the paella gets prepared for 25 minutes, we take a break. On the other side, chef will teach us how to make creme kaatilana. Do come back. Welcome back. Today we come to you from La Latina in GK1, New Delhi. Before the break, chef taught us how to make a seafood paella, and now it's time for dish number two. Make sure you have your pen and paper out. Chef, what are you going to teach us? So chef, tell us about the next dish that you're making.
Yeah, so we are doing creme kaatilana, which is we are doing it in our way. We are doing a savory creme brulee. So we are using goat cheese savory, cream, milk, and on the bottom we are putting the caramelized onion. So I kept some ready.
All right.
And I have the slice too. And the saffron, we are using Kashmiri saffron for that.
Okay.
Yeah. We are just starting it up. So I'm just tempering the saffron with the milk and cream. So I'm just heating it up.
So how many ml, if you could just take us
to? So this is like 100 ml of cream, 100 ml of milk, and 300 gram of goat cheese.
Okay.
Yeah. Together with the milk. Just need to temper the saffron, so a bit of salt. It's very easy to make at home. Like just temper your saffron and mix with this goat cheese savory. Yeah.
Okay.
And when the mixture is ready in a bowl, in a smaller bowl, you can put the caramelized onion in, and you can pour the mixture and set it for like 2-3 hours in the fridge. It will be set, and just once it's ready, just put some sugar on top and brulee it like a creme brulee.
All right.
So that's why we are calling it the savory creme brulee.
Great.
Yeah. So I'm putting all the
This is 300 grams of goat cheese.
300 grams of goat cheese.
All right. And is this the dessert?
No, it's a savory one. So
okay.
That's why I put a bit of salt.
Okay. Yeah. And is one just supposed to have it with a spoon, or do you have put it on
bread?
Yeah.
So we serve with the dehydrated bread. So you can just like break it, because there's a crack on top with the sugar.
Okay.
And you just dip with your dehydrated bread.
All
and
right.
Yeah, it's pretty warm, so we can like bit on the room temp. So otherwise it's like too much, like it will be like melted too much.
Oh.
So that's why.
That will take a while, no?
Yeah.
Can I mix it? This is
yeah,
fun.
Sure. Please.
This is like, it's so fascinating. It's a bit like kheer being mixed with cheese.
You can do with this if you.
Okay.
Yeah.
So how do you do this?
No.
Or you do
yeah,
this?
Yeah, normal. A bit slowly because it's too much liquid. Yeah.
And that's it? You just keep moving it or any particular motion?
So like you can just break the
like
lumps.
This. Okay.
Yeah.
Oh God, they're all going inside.
Yeah.
Am I doing it really badly?
So this is enough. So we'll put like 50-55 ml of this cream and goat cheese. That's it, that's enough. And we can put it in the fridge for like 2-3 hours.
All
so
right.
It will get set.
Okay.
And then we can brulee it.
Okay.
So we already kept one in the fridge. This is already set. And that's the texture before like setting it up.
Okay.
When you kept it in the fridge for like 2-3 hours,
all
this
right.
will be like this.
Amazing.
So we can just sprinkle some sugar on top. Like nicely all over. Make sure there will not be a thick layer of sugar.
Okay.
So it's pretty hard to like.
Yeah.
And we'll just brulee it. And make sure don't burn yourself.
I know.
You can just keep it like down and do it. That will be more easier at home. That's done.
Amazing.
So, and we serve with the dehydrated bread. Just fry and dry in the oven if you want, you can do it.
Amazing. Well, the blowtorch is a definite addition in my kitchen. After the break, we taste the seafood paella and the creme kaatilana. Welcome back to Something Green. Before the break, Chef Aman taught us how to make a seafood paella and the creme kaatilana. Now, I am going to taste it. So how do we eat it? We just dip it?
Yeah, so just bake the... Yeah.
Okay.
So we kept it for... Yeah.
Ooh.
Yeah. A bit deeper so you get the caramelized onion too.
Oh yeah.
Caramelized onion in the base.
Might need some help.
Yeah.
Amazing. Well, this looks fantastic. It's delicious, Chef, and it's so easy to make.
Yeah, it's so
amazing.
Easy to make at home. And if you want to try more tapas plates, so you can refer this book, Tapas. It's a really nice book.
Okay, yeah. I'm gonna order it online immediately, and let's try the paella.
Yeah. You want me to serve it?
Yeah, sure. Thank you. That's fine.
That's fine. That's the...
Thank you.
Sure.
Wonderful. I love the taste and the flavor of paprika.
Yeah, that's the paprika's flavor. It's like smoky and it's good.
Do you think one could add bacon to the paella?
You can add chorizo if you want. Yeah, if you want, you can add chorizo oil too, because authentically they made with the chorizos. Yeah,
the chorizo oil. Really?
And the chorizo too.
That's a great tip. And if you want to keep it only vegetarian, what other toppings can you add?
So you can do like asparagus, you can do artichoke, palm heart.
Tofu?
Tofu, that will be like, it's very soft, so might be the texture wise.
Alright.
I don't prefer to put.
Okay. Well, Chef, this is delicious and all of you must try it at home if you can, because it's fantastic, and all your guests will be in awe of your cooking skills. Chef, thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
And thank you so much for watching.